Okay, we're going to go to Steve, listening in Columbus, Ohio, St. Gabriel Network. How are you, Steve?
I'm doing fine. How are you gentlemen doing tonight?
Fantastic, sir. What's your question for Jim?
First of all, I just wanted to, this is something I've been meaning to do for a while, but I wanted to extend a personal thank you to Jimmy for being a part of my conversion to Catholicism.
Oh, thank you.
I was received into the church back at Easter, at the Easter Vigil, and I just want to thank Jimmy for helping me get there.
Well, thank you, and welcome home, and it's my honor to have been able to play a part in that.
Yeah. Okay, here's a question you can really stretch your legs on. When and I guess maybe how was all of time and the years like renumbered? I mean, when Christ was born, you know, people didn't say, "Oh, well, okay, this is year zero, and we can begin counting up from here."
Okay,
when did all of that renumbering happen?
Okay, so in the ancient world, there was no standard international system of numbering years like we have today with the BC-AD system. Instead, what would happen is they would date years based on certain events, and different countries had different ones. One of the most common ways that they did this, and this happened everywhere in the world, was they would date it based on how many years in office the local ruler had been reigning. So you might say, okay, in the 10th year of King Herod, this happened, or in the 15th year of Augustus, this happened. And so they would use their local ruler as the basis for a numbering system. And then every time they got a new ruler, they had to change that. They had to start over again with year one. In Rome, they had a couple of additional ways of doing it, actually three. One of them was based on the Greek Olympics, because back in the ancient world, people were just as rabid sports fans as they are now. And since the Greek Olympics drew people from all over the world, and since they were held every 4 years, you would have numberings based on which Olympiad you were in. And so you'll find records saying this event happened in the third year of the 184th Olympiad. And because the Olympics were, as I said, international, this got used all over the place, not just in Greece, but in Rome as well. Also in Rome, they would date things based on who the consuls were. Every year there were two consuls. They were elected for one-year terms. Consuls were high officials that were part of the Roman government. And so you would have things dated based on who were the consuls at the time. So you would have things like, in historical documents, it'll say things like, this event occurred in the year of Gallio and Proclus. The Christian era came in 525 AD when a monk in Rome named Dionysius Exiguus, or Dennis the Short, did a renumbering. He did a calculation based on all of the years since Christ was born, and his system eventually became the global standard. So it all happened in the early 500s by Dionysius Exiguus or Dennis the Short.